So today we're going to do the messy, loose beachy waves that everybody wants. Everybody asks me how to do it. So I'm going to show on the lovely model Gemma. Say hi.
I'm just kidding.
And we are first going to apply heat protectant. I'm gonna use just a couple drops. You can kind of see it maybe. Maybe it's too bright. And this is the stuff I'm using. Sulfate-free, paraben-free, cruelty-free. My favorite. All right. And we are going to begin by putting in from the ears down to the ends.
From the ears down.
Yes. Because hair is more stressed or damaged on the ends because it's older hair, it's been through more than the hair up in the root area. So that's why I prefer to put it down here.
And you avoid oiliness on your face, right?
Yeah, that true. True that. And then I just kind of wipe over whatever is left over kind of through the top because we will still be putting the curling iron through there. All right, so wherever you prefer your hair to part, go ahead and work with it in that part. So on Gemma right now, we kind of have a little bit of a zigzag part, but I actually don't mind it. I think it looks really nice. So we're just gonna keep with that. But we're going to separate her hair into two sections. So top section and bottom section. So just think of like the area maybe just above the ears and going back. And then we'll clip this up out of the way. Okay. And then the easiest way to work with your hair, in my opinion, when you're doing it on yourself, is to split it down the middle, bring your hair over your shoulders like so. And then you can start with one section and taking a piece of hair like this. So I would say it's about a few inches going up and then like an inch and a half across. So it's not like a ton of hair, but it's not too little either. And the whole key to this look, I think, is making it so it's not super perfect. So it makes it much less stressful. And then with curling irons, if you're not super, what's the word?
Flexible.
Yeah. And if you're not too familiar and super flexible, and feel comfortable enough using a curling iron on your own, I would first suggest practicing through the motions without the curling iron being plugged in. So you can see how it feels, get used to the motions and whatnot.
So you don't burn your face or your ears or something.
Exactly. Or your neck even. It's happened to me before, so it doesn't feel good. I know, exactly. And I'm using the Marcel kind, so this is the type that hairstylists usually use, but I would say using a spring-loaded one is just as great, and I actually really like those. So we're gonna go ahead and start. I got it all nice and hot. Oh, and as far as the heat setting goes, if you have an adjuster on there, you really don't need any more than 330. That's mm-hmm. probably even higher.
Yeah, that's
actually
pretty high.
Yeah. And this is the degrees Fahrenheit, I think, because this is actually made in the US. Oh no, this is made in China. Dude, everything's made in China.
430. Anyway. That says 430. That's like on fire.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that's Fahrenheit.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably.
So Celsius would be like 300, 320.
Okay, 350. That's what the thing is. I remember now. It's been a while.
Going back to class.
I sound like I really don't know what I'm doing. No, 350 is what is like, you really don't need more than that. Mm-hmm. Anywho, that being said, without further ado,
let's curl.
Curl Patty.
Okay. So are we curling forwards or backwards?
That is a good question. If you feel like you need more fullness in your hair, it's good to switch them back and forth. Mm-hmm. But around the face, I always prefer to curl going back.
Okay, yeah.
That way it stays out of your face. Exactly.
Yeah.
So
in the back, it doesn't really matter too much.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm just going to go ahead and start up kind of towards the top slash middle. And I'm going to go ahead and curl it in. And then I'm going to leave the ends out. I'm not going to bring in the ends. One, it's better for your ends to not curl them, because it keeps them healthier. And also, you want that undone look. So once you've curled it, you just let it sit like so to cool down completely before you even touch it and tousle it and whatnot. So this one I'm having going forward. Actually, going backward, my bad. And then this one here I'll have going forward. I feel like I'm gonna need to redo this whole video. I'm like, okay, Christina, hit all the points you wanna remember.
And then my hair will be a frizz.
Yeah. And it's like, what? Okay, so now I'm gonna do this other side. It's turning out a lot of work.
So what is your favorite outing for this kind of hairstyle?
Oh, everything. Honestly, I feel like this is a style you could totally wear anywhere. And even if you're like going out and you want to like zhuzh it up even more rather than just having it down in messy curls, you could even like, you know, part it over to one side and you'll get more volume.
Oh yeah.
Especially after it's already been set.
Always looking very glamorous.
Yes. You can even pin a side up. Just curl this one back. Since we have this one down. Just gonna let that sit. Okay. So we got the bottom part done. So as far, oh actually, go ahead and curl this part too. Because when we bring down the top section, then we could really get the front part to go back. So down here, it's okay if it goes forward. But I just think about like the sections around it, like from the ears forward, that's a good place to curl it back. Okay, that's good. Okay, so now that we have the bottom part curled, we're gonna let this cool down completely. And then, rather than just letting us all go down and blending and messing up with the bottom parts we've already curled, we can work in sections. So I'm gonna just take this section up around from the ears up to the part, let that down, clip everything else back up so you can let the other curls finish cooling. And I think I'm gonna go ahead and part this vertically and then curl them separately. So these parts are going to be curled back, away from the base. So yeah, if you are familiar with the curling iron, it'll actually go pretty quick. This doesn't take very long to do. And you can sleep on it for a couple days and it still looks really, really good.
Bed hair.
Yes. Or like sexy bedroom hair.
Mm-hmm.
Victoria's Secret hair.
Mm-hmm. That's all about that now.
Yeah. You know what's funny though is like, the thing that stylists back in the US always say, besides like, oh, beachy girl, you know, California girl, they're like, oh, Victoria's Secret hair. I'm gonna give you Victoria's Secret hair.
Yeah.
It's all Victoria's Secret.
I think the colors as well, a lot of girls will say it's not just a natural look, it's the Victoria's Secret colors as well.
Yeah. Like the soft,
still natural.
Like balayage.
Blended.
Yeah. Yeah. Balayage is a very, like, super popular style because, well, one, it's lower maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
It looks more natural. And Victoria's Secret models have it. Okay. So now I'm going to do on this other side. What else is going to go around? Sorry. It's kind of, I feel bad having you turning away from the camera, though. That's the only thing. So, this section. And you don't have to be super precise on like exactly how much hair you need to grab.
These are large. This curling iron is for large curls.
Yes. Good point. So this is an inch and a quarter of a barrel. So it's not too big, not too small. But if you find that you have really hard, a really hard time keeping curl in your hair, it's really good to maybe use a smaller curling iron, maybe try an inch, and then letting it cool down completely. That's the main key, is letting it cool down completely, because when you don't, then it will, like, you pull out the curl and then it ends up setting in the style once it completely cools, because the cooling is what sets it. So, like, for instance, on your blow dryer, if you use the, like, a round brush or something and you use the cool shot button on your blow dryer, it sets the style, so it helps keep it in longer. So that's another little extra tidbit.
I never used my cooling thing.
Oh, really? No. It's really good, maybe for up in the roots especially, if you want more volume.
Right, so you could like brush it and then spray it with the cool.
Yeah. Use that cool shot. Or like if you're getting really hot when you're blow drying, you could just cool yourself down with the cool shot, then, which I do all the time. So for the bangs, oh shoot, I should have done one on camera. Okay, let me yeah. So for the bangs, if you have bangs, you really don't need to focus too much on that part. I would just kind of add a little bit of a bend towards the ends to kind of go back. Just kind of a little bit, just a little bit of a tap on those ends, just as long as the direction is kind of going back.
Great.
All right, so now I'm gonna take another section.
Perfect curl.
Aww. Ba ba boom. And then I can show you doing this side as well. And you know, if you feel like it, maybe the section's a little bit chunky, then you can just even go at a diagonal if you wanted to. You really don't need to go too crazy. But this one, I think I would like to maybe go forward with this, because since these front parts here are going back. And I'm just gonna lay the hair over the clipped area. Like having another clip but not using another clip.
Three hands.
Yeah. And start from the top, work it in. And leaving out the ends. I'd say about a couple inches or so. So let it cool.
I feel like I'm getting ready for like a Friday night.
Yay!
Even though.
Happy Tuesday, y'all!
Yeah, happy Tuesday!
Something to celebrate.
Almost hump day?
Yeah.
Do you say that in America?
Hump yes.
Okay.
Oh my god. Have you seen a commercial where there's like this camel walking through an office building? He's like, hey guys, you know what day it is? And he's like, it's hump day. It is, I don't know. It was really funny. You have to see the commercial. Oh my gosh. I'm like really bad at telling stories.
I can imagine.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like it's in my mind. I'm like, oh my gosh, it's so funny.
Yeah.
Oh. And then it's like, oh gosh, how do I tell it again?
I think I don't know if we only just started talking about hump day, but I hear more and more people saying it now.
Oh really?
So Christina's from America.
California.
So that's why we've got the perfect California hair going on.
Yes.
I'm from Australia and we're here in Shanghai.
Yes, Shanghai, China. And I'm sure some of you know Gemma is a model. Mm-hmm. And so with me being a hairstylist, we obviously met on photo shoots at.
Yeah.
So, and we've been good friends since.
Yeah.
Yay.
And it's perfect because we can do a lot of creative shoots and at least we know that we can have a big chat together for the whole day. So.
Yes.
That's funny.
We always get to come up with some fun ideas too. Mm-hmm. For future shoots and whatnot. And that's another thing about being like in the fun, creative, artistic feel is you meet other people that are also very talented and professional, and you can make some really cool stuff together. It's really fun. Yeah. And even like with photo shoots, like even though they take all day, even they say, oh, it's gonna end at 5, and it's like 5 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
But it's okay, because at the end of the day, you feel accomplished, and then when you see the final result, when everything is edited and just looks so awesome, it's like, oh my god, I made this with these people. It looks so good. And it makes your portfolio look really rad too.
Yeah.
So rad. Little California talk.
Gnarly. <Red. laughs> Christina's also cutting and coloring hair, and as you can see, my bangs are not really bangs anymore.
Grown so. Out.
Next time we're gonna cut them and make a video.
Yeah. Yeah, when cutting fringe on your own, the bangs, it's always really important to not do them on your own.
It's gonna sign that you need sharp scissors, at least. Gosh.
Yeah, and just knowing how your hair is too, because I mean, oh my gosh, there was, like, I don't know, everybody's hair is so different, it lays different, and so it's really important to cut them so that way, like, once you let go of them, they don't, like, spring up into, like, gosh, I'm trying to think of, like, I don't know.
Oh, like the ends going out, not in.
Yeah, that, or like if you have curly hair and you pull down your bangs to cut them and then they like spring up even shorter. It's like, oh, I didn't mean for them to go that short, but.
That's the horror.
Yeah.
The horror.
It's like a scary movie.
Yeah. When I was maybe 7 or something, you know Barbie, there was one edition and she had extensions, so it came with a little pair of scissors. And I was like, oh, I'm gonna use these scissors and cut my hair. So I was left in my room for a couple of hours.
And oh my god.
Yeah, my hair went, you know, like pretty up and around, and yeah. Oh. That's probably the only and last time that I cut my own fringe and everything, so. And these scissors were like the length of half my finger. So the whole time it was like this kind of awkward like cut.
Oh my god.
It's an experience I think everyone needs to try.
Yeah. Like or like the uneven choppy bang. Actually, you know what? I've seen this one little girl before, I remember. She was so freaking cute, but I don't know if her parents like meant to cut her bangs like this or
but like
there was
zigzag.
Like an ick accident. Yeah, this little girl's hair, it was like super like choppy, and she was only like 3 years old or something. So I'm like, oh, maybe she cut them, but they look kind of cool.
Setting trend.
Yeah. One of the few cases when people cut their own.
Mm.
In this case, this girl might be a natural born hair stylist. Alright, we are almost done.
Should I turn?
Oh.
I
know, that's a thing. I feel really bad because like it's like hard to get a good angle for, you know what I mean? To get the so just going back and forth. Except for the front part, remember, from around the ears up, always go back. And the rest, just front back. And the last piece. Oh wait, no, we got two more pieces. I take that back. It's always good to start from the top because not only is that the healthier part of the hair, but also you get more curl up around the top.
Volume.
Yes, and volume for sure. Maybe I'm gonna break this one up. I'm gonna go rogue. I'm gonna grab a little smaller piece. And then I'm gonna go forward. Mix it up. Goes to show it doesn't have to be perfect. As long as everything's like in the general idea. Feels good, looks good. And what I also like to do whenever I'm finished is I always like to grab like a few wispies around the top. So like for instance, take a piece like this back and then I'm gonna curl it back. And then this part, I think I curled. Ooh, that's so pretty. So I'm just gonna put those curls in there. So I'm gonna turn out this way. So when you do this around the crown, I feel like it just adds that little extra bit of oomph and volume and that soft floatiness, like a windblown look. Oh, and I forgot to mention, the curling iron that I'm using, and they do have a spring-loaded version as well, is Hot Tools. They have some good stuff.
What does spring-loaded mean?
So spring-loaded is, so like for instance, this is the Marcel, and it like, there's nothing holding it. Like, you know what I mean? Like it just, it's loose. Yeah. And then you can spin it around like this. The spring-loaded, the handle doesn't spin, it doesn't move around.
I think mine would be spring-loaded then.
Yeah, because you just push it and then it opens. Yeah, yeah, that's spring-loaded. I love spring-loaded, but I just got used to these from beauty school, so.
Yeah.
There you go.
More control. It's like driving a manual car than an automatic or something, right?
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Like, how did I learn and like, yeah.
Yeah, no, it kind of is, actually.
Your hand probably sets to that movement of being able to spin it around.
Yeah. Yeah, you gotta kind of keep in control of the movement, for sure. Otherwise, if you don't do it right, then it goes horribly wrong. Okay, so this pretty much cooled down. So, I'm going to use an oil. For the ends of the hair. I always like to add a little bit more of the pieciness to it. And I don't add it to the roots because you don't really need it on the root. Obviously because your roots already produce its own oil, its own sebum. And the longer your hair is, the drier your ends are. So it's really good to nourish them and to use an oil. And I like natural stuff. I like simple. It's always good. So this one is actually a hair oil that I made, and it's a jojoba-based oil with some essential oils that are really good for the hair, a few drops in there. But if you do make your own, just make sure that you follow along with suggested, recommended concoctions, just because if you can get a really bad allergic reaction if you mix too much essential oil. I've had allergic reactions.
It actually can burn your skin.
Yeah, it can. There are some essential oils that if you have it on your skin and you're exposed to the sunlight, it can create burns, especially like citrus, for instance. Yeah. Like if you have a lime or a lemon, it's very acidic. And if it's on your skin and you're in the sun, you get really bad burns. Mm-hmm. So you definitely want to be careful. You could probably even do a video on the hair oil that I make.
Yeah, this is homemade.
Yeah, and it smells so good. It actually smells like Aveda to me. I love it. Like, did I have you? I think I had you smell it, maybe. It smells well, so good.
No, I don't think I smelled that. Is it lavender as well?
Yeah, there's lavender, yeah. Cedarwood, patchouli. It's amazing. Nice. I love it. So the best thing to do, and if you're using like a dropper, just make sure it's all dropped in there. Close it up.
Shake.
And then go ahead and squeeze, get some in there. A little bit oily from earlier. And then I'm just gonna add 1, 2, 3, 4 drops. She has really thick hair, so I'm gonna start with 4 drops for now. And then I'm going to just rub it in my hands.
Take all the smell first.
Yes, create an experience.
Mm, it's like being in the massage.
Yes, aromatherapy. And then we're gonna grab from the ears down. Oh my god, it's so pretty.
Shiny.
Yes. So, and then just make sure you really get them ends nice and piecey, but it's not too piecey if you're not using too much. And then just kind of use your fingers as like a rake. And notice I didn't use any brush or anything. You really don't need it. I like things nice and easy, low maintenance, and that's part of my low maintenance process. And speaking of low maintenance, even with like shampooing and conditioning, I don't do it every single day. It's not good for it. And if you do shampoo, another tidbit, to shampoo just the root, rinse it out, and then condition from the ears down, clip it up, leave it out of the way while you shower, shave, and then rinse it out at the very end. It's nice. Anywho.
Like, yeah, I'm washing my hair wrong then.
Huh?
I'm washing my hair wrong then.
Yeah. Yeah, gotta do it right.
Mm-hmm.
This is really pretty. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just zhush it up. Look at that.
Damn, we should go for dinner now then.
I know. But that's all you need. Freaking gorgeous. I love it. And then I like that it's not too curly up in the front, right? You just blend it in with the rest. And then you just use your fingers and then kind of zhush up the top. Could even kind of just take it and just kind of do that within reason. All right, and let's spin around and show. Yes, beautiful. That, all those beautiful loose waves. Gorgeous. Maybe have you scooch a little bit more forward this way. Gorgeous.